Welcome to Lyme Time. I'm Allie from the Tick Chicks. We are all more than Lyme disease and chronic illness, and together we stand with you to overcome and rise. I'll bring you closer to the experts in cutting-edge treatments and even a few unexpected ways of healing. I'll ask the questions you want answers to regarding Lyme disease and successful ways of getting you closer to 100%. We are in this together and will not be defined by Lyme. Today on Lyme Time, I'm bringing somebody very, very special to you. And it's a company called Ravel Health. And why am I so excited about this particular episode? The reason is that Ravel Health, I knew about this a couple of years ago, about 3 years ago when they were first starting. And I've been in touch with them over the years, and they are finally launching a program to put health providers and LLMDs in the hands, bring them into your home virtually to treat every Lyme patient out there. And they are in 10 states currently, and by the end of 2025 will be hopefully in all 50 states. So Ravel Health offers affordable care to chronic Lyme patients through monthly telehealth visits with curated, vetted providers. Ravel's mission is to change the way Lyme patients are treated by bringing a more modern online experience to the community and making it easier to find a Lyme-literate provider. Ravel is built by patients for patients. So today I'll be interviewing co-founders and chronic Lyme patients themselves, Jamie Intley and Kevin Williams. And before we get started, I just want to welcome them both here today and ask each of them to give us a little sense of their Lyme disease journey and their past and what led them to co-creating Ravel Health.
My name is Jamie Intley. I'm one of the co-founders of Ravel. I grew up on the East Coast in New Jersey. And I was bit by the only tick bite that I know of was in the third grade. And I came home from like a school field trip and I thought it was like a little pimple in the top of my head. And my mother at least knew enough. It was like the early 80s to take me to a doctor at the time and have it removed. But cut to my mid-30s. I mean, nothing happens to me as a child that I can really remember or is like a very significant event until like my mid-30s when I was just going through a lot of life changes and I started feeling like I didn't know what was happening to my mind and to my body, but I knew something was wrong. And I saw a ton of doctors. Nobody could really figure it out. And then cut to my like early to mid 40s, I was bit by a dog. A neighborhood dog bit my forearm and he like punctured my lymphatic system. And I had like full blown Lyme, like right from there, like just, had all the symptoms that I had been feeling for the last like decade just all came up. And it took me several years to find my tribe of, you know, healers, providers that, you know, helped me. I went the holistic homeopathic herbal route for my own healing. And here we are today. So I don't know if that was.
Yes. Thank you so much. Yeah. Thank you. It's a very similar story to a lot of those who are listening to the Lyme Time podcast today, just having initial interaction with a tick, so to speak. And then not feeling something for years and years until something else triggers it. So very, very relatable story. Kevin, what about you?
Yeah, so for me, things came on a little bit more slowly. It was roughly 2007. I was very active playing sports and, you know, probably close to the best shape of my life. I just completed a half marathon, sprint triathlon, and then all of a sudden started getting weird sort of cramping in my hands and feet, which started spreading to my legs, kind of that migratory muscle pain, which wasn't really aware of that was associated with Lyme at the time. You know, I was playing sports. I couldn't catch my wind. My knee would give out. And that, you know, progressed from there to GI issues, a lot of bloating, full really quickly, just kind of stomach pain. And then from there, progressed to more of the neuro issues, you know, over the course of probably 2 or 3 years. So, you know, at its worst, you know, massive brain fog, memory issues, bouts of dizziness, you know, 25, 30 times a day. Got to a place where I had difficulty walking, so I thought I had MS. And, you know, at that point, you know, I'd gone to my primary care physician, I don't know how many times, and realized that that person had no idea what was going on. And then spent the next probably like 5 to 7 years, you know, seeing same story that, you know, most of us in the, you know, community have seen 20, 30 different providers to try to figure out what was going on. And then was finally diagnosed, I think it was like 2017. So about 10 years after the initial symptoms started.
Wow, that's incredible. And what I find especially wonderful about Ravel Health is the fact that you two come from a Lyme disease background. You've lived it, you've walked it, you've experienced it, you have dealt with all of the frustrations of getting to the right providers, understanding even from the beginning what it is you even need from these providers. And so I think Ravel Health offers a very unique way of treating your patient the way you would have wanted to be treated from the very beginning. Let's talk a little bit about the Ravel Health. And of course, you know, let's start from the beginning. What is the application process, if you will? And can you just sort of walk me through that? I know that Ravel offers affordable virtual care for Lyme disease. So take us through those first sign-up moments.
Yeah. So when patients come to the website, if they live in one of the 10 states that we're currently live, they're able to move forward in the process I'm about to explain. If they don't live in one of those 10 states, we will be nationwide by the end of next year. So there is a waitlist opportunity for people to sign up, and then we just keep you posted as we go live across the country. Basically, patients come to the site and they fill out a brief questionnaire on our patient portal. It's called the Initial Patient Questionnaire. It's about 10 to 15 questions, and it gives us a better understanding of who you are, your patient health history, what you've already done, and what you are open to doing moving forward. The responses to this to help us and our chief medical officer match you with up to 3 Lyme literate providers. Currently, this is a manual process. I should kind of back up that we just launched our pilot here in Colorado last October. So we're almost a year into being live in Colorado, but then about four months being live in 9 other states. So currently the process is that we work with our chief medical officer to match you with up to 3 Lyme literate providers. We then send the patient those 3 providers' bios that we have worked directly with them to craft. The patient chooses who they want to work with. They can certainly get back in touch with us and ask us any, you know, clarifying questions. But the patient chooses who they want to work with. They are matched in our patient portal. And then from there, the patient has their initial patient visit. The initial patient visit is 2 hours. And then from there, after the initial patient visit, the patient can choose anywhere from 30, 60, or 90 minutes on a monthly basis to meet with their provider. So we are a monthly subscription plan. We did this so that there is continuity of care. Kevin and I know as patients ourselves that even when you're an established patient with a provider, sometimes it's hard to get in. You might be having a flare. You might want to review labs. You might want to have a mid, you know, protocol review. You might be sick. So, you know, some other type of virus or something else is going on, and you want to be able to get a hold of your provider. So that's why we do the monthly subscription. But the patient can upgrade and downgrade monthly depending on where they are in their own health journey and what is coming up for them. And again, we did that because we know that, like, from the patient perspective, choosing how, where, when you spend your money and knowing that you have an opportunity to meet with your provider monthly was really important to us.
It's so brilliant that you're doing a sort of a scaled version of payment. I mean, how often do you have a quick question that you know can be answered in about 20 to 30 minutes and any, you know, just a quick check-in, and you don't want to be burdened with a 90-minute, you know, cost? And so I think it's really, really user-friendly. I love this process. I think I'm excited about it because I think a lot of people, it will reach so many more people because that it's really geared toward the patient, in my opinion.
Yeah. And actually, just to clarify one thing there, just to your point, because we ran the pilot back in October through March of this year, we kept the pilot really small and we were able to really get a lot of feedback from the patients and the providers. We stayed very close to everybody going through it. And some of the feedback that we got from patients and the providers was about making adjustments to the subscriptions. And so, to your point, we did do that. And back in April, we launched a couple other subscription opportunities for existing active Ravel patients. So once they've had a few appointments, they are able to move to what we're calling maintenance. And that's like an opportunity for patients who have worked with their provider for at least 3 consecutive months and feel like maybe in that 4th, 5th, or 6th month, whatever, they don't necessarily need to have another appointment, but they would still like to maintain access to their provider, and they still want to maintain access to all the discounts that we offer with our labs and the supplement companies that we work with. So that's an opportunity that, you know, so that's something that came out of directly the patient feedback. Another thing to your point is that the patients also have an opportunity that they could have like a 15-minute patient portal question and answer session where they don't have to have, you're right, like a 60 or a 90-minute appointment. They might need to get some clarification on something, and it's more than just like a yes, no question in the patient portal. So they have an opportunity to also purchase 15 minutes with their provider. So we're really trying to stay very in touch with all of the patients and making sure that we're accommodating as we hear feedback and it makes sense.
Oh, it really makes sense. I love that. I wish all doctors offered that personally. So once everybody's signed up, they've filled out the application and they've done a brief questionnaire, and they've talked to you and you've given them the 3 LLMDs, so to speak, and they've got their choices. They go ahead and do their research on the 3 choices that they have. And then they have their initial consultation for 2 hours, and then they just will decide with their provider where to go from there. Is there any patient out there that this type of health structure wouldn't be appropriate? In other words, if somebody's in an acute, extreme distress or something like that, how do you handle those cases?
Yeah. So, excuse me, in those scenarios, so we do try to be very clear that we're, you know, providers aren't on call. You know, they're not available for like emergency services per se. So if somebody is having something acute happening, we do recommend that, you know, they either contact their primary or go into an ER, or if it's really an emergency, call 911. So we aren't set up to accommodate those types of situations. It's really more of your sort of typical appointments and kind of follow up on a monthly basis with patients.
That's really good too. Let's, you know, make sure and highlight that. That's great. The doctors, let's talk about the doctors. When you were interviewing and accepting certain doctors into the program, What types of criteria did you have?
So we have a vetting process that we go through. So Kevin and I have been working together for 3 years, and we have been speaking to providers all over the country. And a lot of times we are building the relationship over, you know, many months to really to get to know somebody, to understand how they practice, you know, the types of patients that they bring into the practice. And we really look for providers that who truly believe in what we are doing and what our mission is. And the mission is to change the way Lyme patients are treated. One of the goals is to offer affordable care, but they need to really truly believe in the mission. So we spend a lot of time going, you know, building that with them. And then in a more kind of formal process, we have them fill out a provider questionnaire, which is more than just their career history. It really goes into a lot of their background, a lot of their training, their education, you know, courses that they've taken, things like that. So it really, you know, who their, you know, mentors are, things like that. So we go into that whole process. And then from there, we have them interviewed from either one of our advisory board members, and then also our chief medical officer. So we go through like a more formal interview process. And after all of that, we go through a more formal background check where we are really checking on the provider's license, any malpractice cases, things like that, that may have come up over their career. So we do a background check also. And then we start working together.
Sorry, go ahead. Yeah. If one of those options for them turns out that they're maybe they're having second thoughts about maybe one of the other providers that they were referred to by you guys initially, is there an opportunity to change courses at some point?
Yes, there definitely is. So that's, you know, one of the benefits I would say that we offer through Ravel that you might not necessarily get through other clinics. So, you know, we hope that we've, you know, done enough due diligence kind of on all sides to make a good match to begin with. But if for some reason, you know, a patient chooses a provider and they don't resonate, or, you know, for whatever reason, they, you know, would like to potentially see someone else, we do have a process in place to do that. So we do ask that patients, you know, have at least, you know, a couple appointments with their provider just to, you know, kind of give it a chance. As we all know, right? Testing treatment when you're talking, you know, this population can often take time to, you know, sort of see results. But yes, if patients do want to change, you know, after that time period, there is a small cost just because there is, you know, a lot of administrative stuff that goes along with changing providers. But patients do have the ability to do that.
Right. Can you tell me what states, so we're doing this interview in September of 2024. Can you tell me as of today, what states you do service?
Yeah.
Yes.
We are live in Colorado, Connecticut, Iowa, Montana, Minnesota, Nebraska, Pennsylvania, Texas, Washington, and Wisconsin.
Wow. That's a lot. And I'm sure you're, as you mentioned, you're expanding that and hope to be in all 50 states by the end of 2025. So that's
the goal.
Exciting.
I'm sure it'll happen before that, but that's the goal.
That's wonderful.
And we are looking, just a quick note, we are looking at potentially going into California, Illinois, and North Carolina here pretty shortly as well.
I love the sound of that. We need you here in California. Let's talk a little bit about the technical stuff. What could a patient expect in terms of insurance coverage? And if they can't use their insurance, what other things can you offer through Ravel?
So Ravel is cash pay at the moment. With that being said, we do provide super bills upon request. So patients can get a super bill and submit that to their insurance. Depending on their insurance, you know, that's kind of done offline outside of Ravel. Some of that can be covered. And then with certain other things, like testing, for example, through LabCorp and Quest, the default is that those tests are run through a patient's insurance. We do have cash pay panels available as well for patients, but that is the default. So it kind of depends a little bit on what you're talking about. Generally speaking, pretty much everything is cash pay, but is the ability for super bill and some things like labs, you know, kind of general labs, default to insurance.
That's great, because that's basically what I get from my providers at this time anyway. They're not really taking insurance for a lot of Lyme issues. So wonderful to know that we can still have the same process going on in a virtual setting, which is wonderful. They can be in their home in bed if they wanted to and have this great access to doctors, like you just said. What kind of doctors do you have? For instance, what backgrounds are they? Do they have their degrees in, or what specialties do they have? And do you work with all different kinds of doctors? Are they offered to the patient?
We have three naturopaths. So I should say we launched the pilot back in October with 7 providers, including our chief medical officer, and we launched with 30 patients. So of those, we have, so everybody was licensed in Colorado because that's the only place that we ran the pilot. So some of our providers live around the country, but they also have a license to treat patients that are in Colorado. So we have 3 naturopaths. We have 2 MDs and we have 1 NP. We are in the process of speaking to providers all over the country that not only have a license in the state in which they reside, but are also open to getting a license in other states across the country. So that's how we will expand. And we are talking to MDs, DOs, NDs, PAs, NPs. Yeah, so we will be expanding. Everyone who works for Ravel now as a contracted provider has Lyme and mold as a specialty.
Wonderful. Okay, that's great.
Just,
can we
just
talk?
A quick note there. I think sure. Oh, I just had wanted to mention, Jim, I think you mentioned 1 NP. We actually have 2 nurse practitioners, and one of them.
Oh, I forgot about Bethany. Sorry. Yeah, yes.
No worries at all. I just want to mention that one of them actually focuses on pediatrics. So we're really, really excited to have her on board.
Oh, that's amazing. Especially hard to get your child to a doctor appointment.
We have a couple providers who do see adolescents, but she is specifically a pediatrics NP.
Great. Let's talk a little bit about what the scale of the costs involved would be. So I know you had mentioned the shorter 15-minute opportunities down the road, but initially, what is the initial consultation? And then talk me through what the costs would be for a 30, 60, or 90-minute follow-up.
You do really quick. So the initial consultation is $395. And that's for 2 hours. And that also includes all of the, you know, we essentially build in the prep time and then, you know, kind of post appointment time for the provider to complete their encounter note, you know, get any supplements entered into the EHR, things of that nature. And then the follow-up appointments, 30 minutes, 60 and 90. Again, the patient can choose whatever they need on a monthly basis and upgrade and downgrade. The 30 minutes is 115. 60 minutes is 215, and then 90 minutes is 305.
Okay, great. And then what about those shorter 15-minute calls down the road?
So the 15 minutes is actually for in-depth questions through the patient portal. So that's actually messaging specific, so not necessarily a call. So that's $45. So that's if a lot of times, you know, patients will have quick questions just following up, just specifying something with a protocol or wanting to like update their appointment time, something like that. So there's no charge for that, of course, but if they have Oftentimes patients will send messages, like we don't limit, the length of the message or anything. So sometimes patients will include like 10 to 12 questions for a provider, or ask them to review labs sort of offline in between appointments. So that's what that 15-minute portal messaging is for, and that's $45.
Great. And then you had mentioned discounts. What could a Ravel patient expect regarding discounts?
Yeah, and then just one quick note too on sort of the subscription side, the maintenance plan. After a patient has worked with a provider, so we ask that they do the initial patient visit and two follow-up visits. If they want to move to maintenance after that, that's just $65 a month for that. And again, that gets them access to their provider and then those discounts. The discounts sort of across the board. So we have discounts on the lab testing. So with sort of the basic testing through Quest and LabCorp, again, that defaults to insurance. But if you wanted to do cash pay panels, that is, you kind of know what the costs are up front, and that is significantly cheaper than, sort of running something through insurance if you have to pay on a deductible. So we spent time kind of crafting these panels for patients. For specialty testing, we work with Rupa, who is an aggregator and pulls together all these different specialty tests. And those tests are wholesale, and we've actually negotiated with Rupa to get their fee, which was actually 7%, down to zero. So we're pretty excited about that.
Wow.
So there is, just so patients know, we try to be very transparent on all of our pricing. There is a $30 fee, which is for the provider to review and interpret the test results. But that's sort of the only thing tacked on. Rupa doesn't apply their fee anymore for Ravel patients. And then on the supplement side of things, we work with Full Scripts and Whole Scripts. So Full Script right now, it's a 20% discount on all supplements. And then if patients set up sort of recurring monthly orders, there's an additional 5% there, so 25% off total. And then Whole Scripts, 15% off anything there. We also have a partnership with Beyond Balance, and that's completely wholesale. So that's like, I think it comes out to like 41% off of MSRP. So there's a pretty massive discount on Beyond Balance supplements. And then we work with DesBio as well currently and have 15% off there. They do a lot with kids and pediatrics. Their line is sort of kind of catered to that group of patients. And then we're looking to actually get some more partnerships here in place pretty soon. So we got some calls on the books on that front. And then we also have some other partner programs in place that we're sort of refining right now, but we'll be doing some things like we have a partnership with someone who has a mold dog who can actually, send a dog into the home to sniff for mold versus some of the other more like standard testing. So we'll have some discounts there. And then we're also doing some stuff about around brain retraining. So we have a partnership with the Gupta program. So Ravel patients get $100 off of the annual fee for the Gupta program. And we're looking into neurofeedback and some photobiomodulation as well. So we'll have some pretty significant discounts, on that front coming up too. And we'll continue to add to those other modalities and partnerships.
That is so exciting. I mean, that's a very, very wonderful list. And for anybody out there listening to Ravel Health and what it has to offer on this episode of Lyme Time, I don't really know one-stop shopping that can offer these kinds of discounts on everything that the Lyme patient is looking for. And as everybody knows, it's not a one pill cures all here. This is a multi-leveled, layered, angled approach to actually healing Lyme. None of us on this here today have healed our own Lyme disease journey by just doing one thing. We didn't just take a magic pill. We incorporated a lot of different elements into the fold, and by offering discounts on some of the major players in those areas, you're able to offer the Lyme patient just so much, just with, just one-stop shopping. And that's what I find really impressive about this. So on we have the sort of the 2 hour initial consultation cost and then the costs thereafter with some of the shorter appointments with the doctors. Is there a membership, an annual membership, or is there a membership price on top of those payments?
No, we don't have a membership requirement at this time. We do encourage patients to at least stay on the platform for 3 months.
Yeah.
So
I would
we do
say,
have a
I agree with
patient.
That.
Yeah, we do have like a patient agreement that all the patients sign, including all of their consent forms that they need to sign. We're like a regular, it's sort of like when you go to the doctor's office, you have to sign, you know, all the compliance stuff. So in the patient agreement, we do suggest that you stick with your provider for 3 months.
I think that's fair. I think it's really fair to, you know, and if they have to, absolutely have to make a change with their provider down the road, that's one thing. But the idea is to stay with something for at least a year, I would even say, because
that's what we feel. I mean, I wish we could have said somewhere between 6 and 12 months, but you know, we want to reduce the barrier of entry. We do want to streamline the process, make this easier for patients. We're coming at this from the patient perspective. So, but we are always taking feedback. We're always talking to the patients. You know, we're still, I mean, we're the founders, but we are very hands-on. We speak to patients all the time. We guide them through the entire onboarding process. They're speaking to us directly. They're texting us, they're emailing us. So we are building relationships with everybody, and we are always taking feedback. So, just because something is the way it is at this moment doesn't mean if someone's hearing this in 6 months from now that, you know, something hasn't, you know, like evolved essentially. So that's why, you know, we really were very happy that we could make a lot of changes back in April based on feedback from the pilot. We were able to do that. So we hear you, we're here for you along the way. We're patients ourselves, and we are very open to making adjustments and hearing what people have to say. We have been working with patients individually when they have a very specific situation. We're still, you know, young enough that we are able to do that. So
I think that's great. I mean, just really, I don't know how, I guess it was 3 years ago, I first heard about Ravel, and we had a conversation over text, I think it was. And
yeah, I think I messaged you over Instagram or something.
Yeah, the DM, the famous DM. And
yeah.
And so I've been waiting for this for a long time, for the actual launch of this. And I'm excited that it's available in 10 states and counting as we speak. And I'm excited about what's to come in 2025. I think it's an incredible concept. I think you two are really onto something here. I think that you'll be able to reach many, many more Lyme patients. When they talk to me, they say, I live in rural blah, 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 you know, in the middle of nowhere. They can barely get a vitamin drip IV if they need one of those, much less somebody that understands and educates about Lyme disease and the process that you need to get to the end and to back to your health. So I'm very excited that we're partnering and we're collaborating and we're finding different ways to get the word out about Ravel. And I would like to ask you each, as we sort of wrap this up, by the way, you can find Ravel Health through the tickchicks.com. I have a link right there on my homepage. And a little bit more about the company and my resources page. But would you guys also tell us where else you can be found and how the best way for people to find you? And also, just in wrapping up, any message, any personal thoughts or advice or message that you want to get out to our listeners today about their Lyme disease journey?
Yeah, I think the easiest way for... Sorry, Jim. For people to find us is to go to our website, which is just ravel.health. We've been pretty heads down for the last, year with the pilot and the follow-up. So we're still working on building out our socials, but we do have, social pages as well, across all the big social media platforms. If somebody wanted to go there, and the one thing I would just convey, I think, it's been, for a lot of us, right? It's been a long journey. For me, it started like 17 years ago now, and though I'm a lot better, I'm still, not close to 100%. And there were a lot of pitfalls and frustrations along the way. And that's really informed the genesis of Ravel, just trying to, on one hand, like make all of those really bad years count for something good. But then really just try to build something that, can help others avoid, those pitfalls and frustrations. So.
Thank you.
For me, I think, just a thought that I think really helped. I had been really working. Well, I had been looking for my healers. I had been scouring and falling down rabbit holes and trying anything and anyone who gave me some glimmer of hope or said that they could heal me or that they had the answer, and I clung to them. And it wasn't until I was like sitting in somebody's office one day, I was waiting for a treatment, and they had this quote about healing coming from within and not waiting for somebody outside of you to heal you, that really only comes from inside of you. I'm paraphrasing, but that's what helped me. That like this light bulb went on. Like I had heard people say things like that before, that, like listen to your heart, like it comes from within. And I just could not grasp the concept of that until one day I did. And it just, to me, that's really important, is believing in yourself, believing that healing and health is always possible. And having that come from within you. No one else can heal you but you.
You know,
that's how I feel.
I say it all the time, and I don't think it really hits people until it's meant to hit people.
Yeah.
Because it's such a simple statement, but it's actually so powerful. And who's in charge of finding the right doctors? You are. There's nobody else in the driver's seat. It's up to you. And so by finding companies like Ravel Health, picking up that phone and making that phone call and applying and filling out that questionnaire could be the first step in total health and healing for that patient. And I think you guys have made it a lot easier just by offering one-stop shopping. And I wish you so much luck. I know that I'd like to, I'm sure, catch up with you again in about a year and see where we are. And we'll be rambling off a long list of states where everybody can be treated. And I'm just so thrilled that you gave your time today to the Lyme Time podcast. Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks, Sally. Thanks for hosting
us.
Sally.
Yeah, I really appreciate it.